everyone, and welcome back to Let's Play Rabi-Ribi. In the last episode, we went and did a bit of exploring off the beaten path, and, let me just find this warpstone here. There we go. Yeah, we went and explored a little bit of the sky-high bridge. I've also been doing a bit of scouting around of some of the nearby maps to see what other places I can explore, so if you don't see any achievements or things pop up while playing the game, it's because I already explored those areas on another file. But it's been a while since my last video, so this will be a mostly new experience for me. Yeah, this Let's Play is becoming a little less and less blind as I go along, but hopefully it won't be the case forever. So, let's check out the Sky High Bridge and see what's up there. Alright then. Let's see. Is there anything down here I can explore? Oh, jeez. Getting attacked by enemies is never a good thing. There we go. Okay, we're back down here, so let's see what's over here. Oh, it's another Zambunny, and very tight quarters. Come on, get back over here. Alright. What's up here? Yeah, these are rabbit-themed thwomps. They will crush you if you get too close to them. It won't kill you, but it's still kind of irritating, and good gravy, there are lots of annoying enemies there. Okay, I guess I can't go up there just yet. Let's get away from you. And go down here. Oh no! There's a thing there! But I can't get it, because I can't slide or whatever. Wait, can I slide? No. No, there's no sliding or crawling move in this game yet. Or rather, I think there is, but I don't think I have it yet. Oh, hush you. But yeah, once again, sorry for not really putting out many videos, if at all, because stuff's been going on. I just get distracted by other projects and other things I want to do. And recently, Pokemon Sun and Moon came out, so I started doing a quote-unquote Nuzlocke of that. Actually, no, it is a proper Nuzlocke. It's a blind Nuzlocke, and that's a brand new game I never played, but it's still a Nuzlocke nonetheless, and I intend to complete it. So let's see how difficult the game can be. And you just fall into the pit. Okay, sure, fair enough. Get you out of the way. This almost feels, again, this kind of reminds me of a Rose and Cruzette to an extent. There's a sky castle level. And here's a health power-up. Very nice. So let's, wonder what happens if I keep falling down. I think I'll just keep exploring this upper portion a little bit more. Oh! Now that's just mean! Man, I really wish I had some kind of upward attack. Because being well, I have an upward attack, but I don't have a mid-air attack. Because that sort of thing would be useful. And of course, curiosity gets the better of me. Oh! As does the laser. Jerk. Hey, just die already, please. Irritating little enemies. This place is not your friend. I guess you could say this is a battle on the big sky bridge. It's over this way. Oh, there's a save point here. That's good. I'm gonna just ignore you a lot. While it is a good idea to fight any enemies you come across for extra experience and money, sometimes it's just not worth the effort. Oh dear. No, I'm not gonna keep going because if it's one thing I hate, it's dark levels with limited light. And not even your magic can light this place up. It's irritating. So, no thank you. And I don't have the time or patience to figure out a safe route for that area, so back down we go. I guess that laser has limited range. Why did I call it a lemon? It's weird. Well, in any case, here we are. We are at the save point for this area. So, let's see what's in the next room. Oh, I thought there was a boss here. Excuse me! Save points usually indicate there's a boss just up ahead, from this game's logic. But I guess my memory failed me. Okay, boost is ready, at least. Here, eat laser. And there we go. I saw an egg back there. I don't think I can get it yet. Well, I can wall jump up there, but I just can't quite reach that ledge. Yeah, see? Can't quite jump that far. Right then, so let's keep going. Hey, who's this? Looks like a cat girl? Well, she seems happy to see us. Wait, what? You don't look scared to me. Oh, great, not this again. You won't like her when she's angry, apparently. Oh, seriously? Oh, boy. And here it goes. Yep, we have to fight Vanilla now. And she loves to jump! Oop. That was not a good thing to have happen. Oh, pff. I jumped right into that, but I didn't take any damage, so... Now she's behaving like a regular Toho boss. Get out of the way. Uh-oh. Something's happening. She apparently knows some kind of light magic? And ow! And now she's vanished. I don't think I've ever seen her use this attack before. Yeah, I did do this fight once before, like I mentioned, so... Let's see what else she can do. Laser light show of doom. That was some tight dodging there. Fight laser lift with laser. Oops. Curvy lasers of doom. Okay, here comes her super attack. Ooh! And I am very bad at dodging bullets, apparently. Well, that'll be the end of you. Different how? Well, yeah, that is pretty unusual. Then again, so are cat girls and dog girls and whatever other animal-like beings we have in this world. Everyone seems to know Rumi. She's quite the popular woman. Well, okay then. I guess we have a new objective now, to look for Vanilla's sister. Well, I will admit, Vanilla's kinda cute, but... huh? Oh, right. Okay, then. So now we've found two helpers. We need to go back to the village to progress the plot. Oh, wait. Yeah, it's a ways back to the save point. But we're not gonna go to the save point just yet. In fact... oh. Jerk. In fact, I want to go up here for a brief spell. You're new. And now you're dead. You two are also dead. Oh dear, yeah, you want to stay away from those bunnies with the ring attacks, because they will debuff you if they hit you. Get out of my way. I want the health up, but I can't get up there. Oh well, let's move on. Speaking of which, we haven't seen that witch girl lately. I forgot her name, but we haven't seen her in a while. Ooh. Get out of my face. Let's use the save point first. What's in here? I said, what's in here? Who are you? This is still the library? Library? But how are you supposed to get up there? Double jump? Fly? Huh. Well, it certainly seems like something that's a little out of place here. Well, there's not much else we can do here now, so let's go look at the real reason why I'm here. Yeah, that was overkill, but I don't care. That's a little unpleasant. What's this? Auto earrings. Automatic fire when charging. Hmm. Let's try that. Well, I'm not really firing it at the moment. Hmm. Guess it has a really, really slow auto fire. Besides, I already have this spell, so I don't have to worry about auto firing anyways. Get you a hole out of the way. Oh, goody. Here's what I was looking for. Warp stone here. Now that I've activated it, I can teleport back here whenever I want. So let's do that. Let's use this stone and teleport back to Rabi-Ribi Town. Let's go visit the shop while we're here. Alright. Book of Carrot. Regenerate BP over time. Oh, right, yeah. You know, this is a very good, useful combo to get. So, let's buy this. And buy the max bracelet. There we go. So, once Ribbon's gauge is completely maxed out, she can use a max boost attack, which is even stronger than the normal one. So let's go and... Hi, Vanilla! Let's go and have a look-see at that stelae. Eh, I wouldn't call it quickly. You know me, I like to explore a little bit. Okay. Yes, we have two helpers, a cat girl and a crazy scientist. Hmm. Well, I think we're sufficiently ready to take on what's on the other side of this this thing, this teleport. I like Ribbon's face there. He's all like puffy, pouty cheeks. Alright, yeah, let's get going. Oh, so Miru is Rumi's sister. Okay. What's this? Oh, the buddy amulet. Huh. Well, we'll definitely have to take a look at that bunny amulet once we complete this cutscene. Again, any highly advanced technology is indistinguishable from magic. And why do you have a bandage over your eye? I didn't hit you that hard! Shazam! And away we go. Chapter 2, A Little Peek. I'm not so sure about that title game. Huh? Well, this is an interesting group of townspeople. Just say you're a cosplayer, and I'm surprised those other two didn't react to Erina's presence. Those are called buildings, Erina. Which direction? Odd. There's no, waypoint to go by. Can I look at the map? Well, it looks like, there's some areas that haven't been explored. Not entirely sure what this place is. Some kind of city. Well, we might as well go right and see if we can find anything. What's going on? Why did everything go black? Oh no. Player 2 has appeared. And we get a tutorial on how to use the amulet. So yeah, the bunny amulet is basically your bomb for this game. And I have no idea what this illusion is trying to do to us, but it can't be good! Hey! You're not gonna get me this time. Okay, you got me that time. That blue shot is surprisingly hard to dodge. What's more, she debuffs you every time she hits you. So here, have a hammer to the face. She's tossing out the carrot bombs. And using some other... I guess she's using boost attacks, too. I'm stuck. Take that, and let's finish her off with style. BAM! She's exploding! That's not a good sign, is it? Good thinking, Erina. So, where are we now? Oh, we're back in town. And we're back. Well, unfortunately, we didn't really accomplish all that much. Oh well. Well, at least we have some new objectives now. So, Rabi-Rabi Ravine. Well, that's a new location we can check out, and oh, crud. Sayaro. Oh, don't worry, the computer is just a big old box where lots of magic things happen. The curiosity is spreading like a ravenous disease. So we can actually teleport on this little quote-unquote side quest. So, why don't we go out and help Cicini? I don't see why not. We'll be fine. See, we're already in a nice, peaceful-looking, forest. How are you talking to us? Either she's broadcasting her voice out loud, or she gave Erina another, communicator thing. I don't know. All right, then. So yeah, we're in a brand new location, the Eastern Highlands. And you don't have to worry about this place. It is possible to get back. In fact, if you go to the left here, you'll wind up back in the starting forest with bees attacking you! Can I pull up these blocks? I forget if I can or not. Nope. These blocks are indestructible. Not that it matters, because I can easily clear this jump. But yeah, if we keep going right, we'll wind up back here, though we can't go up here just yet. Don't have enough height on our jumps, which is kind of irritating. And why not? Let's bomb the bunny creature here. And dead. Okay, just making sure there wasn't anything hidden there. So let's continue on our way. How does something stay perpetually twilight or nighttime anyways? Well, it's not really a mystery that can be solved right away, so let's just keep going. Also, take note of the spikes there. They hurt. Oh. You again. Get out of my face. Still can't get down there yet. But there's a save point here, too, and I think there's also a warp stone up ahead. Irisu's back. And she's off once again into the ruins we're coincidentally going to. Yeah, I'm curious myself. I want to know what her deal is, so let's keep following her. Make sure we have this warp point logged in. Oh, why'd I do that? Eh. Oh well. Right then, let's just keep going. Oh great, a new enemy type. Spiders. They're annoying, but they're not too hard to get rid of. Okay, we're supposed to head down here, but I'd actually like to keep going to the... Oh, wow. You're an unexpected little surprise. There we go. Get you guys out of the way. Yeah. At least Cicini's pretty chill about us exploring a little bit, so... We might as well take a look around. Eh, nothing there, and I think we need that block anyways to get up to this ledge. Get out of my face. Nothing there. Durable little bugger, aren't you? Nothing there. Get out of my face. Oh dear. Aggressive little Kirby balls of doom. Let's keep going. Ninjini knockoffs. Oh, what do we have here? Attack grow. Ah. Do a little bit more damage. Interesting. And why not? We could use a bit more damage. Is there anything else in here? I just want to make sure, because you never know with these Metroid-style games. They always love hunting. Hooding? Hiding. Hiding goodies everywhere. And I think that just takes us back to the save point. Ooh. Get you out of the way. Well, this looks pleasant. Ow. Losing a lot of health very quickly. So, let's not lose anymore and go back down. back all the way over here. Oh well. I need to go back to the save point anyways. That spike room was not very pleasant. Good. Wait, am I full? Yes, I am full. Yeah, if I'm pausing to... You know, whenever I'm not talking, I usually pause to get something to drink. Is there anything down here? I want to say there is, but... Oh! Would you look at that? It looks like we're underneath that one-way ledge from earlier. That's good. What's over here? Well, whatever it is. Oh, I can't get that item yet. That's unfortunate. And I think I missed another item too, so... Oops. Can I get back up from here? Nope, I couldn't. Darn. Well, I guess I'm not getting an item yet. Yeah, Oh, right, enemies can be hurt by spikes too, apparently. Oh yeah, that's right. I told you guys a story about that in the previous video. Yeah, not really much else to say here. Jump, shoot, dodge bullets. The whole shebang. When in doubt, hammer drill! And I can't get over this ledge. So, I guess we're gonna keep going down. Alright, I should probably talk a little bit about water. When you're underwater, your movement is slower, but your character can jump much higher, kind of like in the Mega Man games. And the music changes too, that's a nice touch. Rid of all you. Come on, join me in the pool. And she didn't hurt me, but she hurt me, but she didn't give me a status effect. So I think I'm okay for now. This attack up is proving itself quite useful, though. Get out of my face, I'm trying to work here. That's all those enemies, but unfortunately, we seem to have hit a bit of an obstacle here. As soon as I'll get rid of you. I can't break these blocks! My shot has no effect on them! Well, shoot. Well, now what? Getting swarmed by enemies, not a good sign. Well, let's just go through these blocks here and find us another power-up. The Bunny Whirl! Whirling jump attack. Ah, there we go. That's the aerial attack I was thinking of. Finally! You can even bounce off of enemies with it if you're good enough. Oh, she got me. Yeah, numb is kind of an irritating status effect. It's about as bad as a paralysis from Pokemon. It randomly limits your movement. Right then. Makes dealing with these spiders so much easier. Yeah, get out of my face. Yeah, not really much to say here. Can I go back up? Well, I'm on the surface again. Can't go that way, though. Oh, another health pickup. Always nice. Is there anything hidden here? Looks like there's enough room for it. Guess not. Oh well. Let's continue onwards. Into another dark place. Oh dear. Oh good, it's not the so dark you can't see your surroundings kind of dark. So we're okay. So, where are we now? Alright. Excuse my slurping. Find the computer room in exotic laboratory? Okay then. And no, I'm not going to make the obvious Sonic Heroes reference. That's been kind of done to death already in my eyes. Nah. Oh dear, that's kind of irritating. So we have your typical factory slash laboratory level. And there's a save point here, but I'm not going to use it right away. Though that being said, I'm almost at 45 minutes, so maybe it'd be a good idea to pause here for now. Alright then. Wait, did I save over the right one? Eh, it doesn't matter. In any case, thank you for watching this video, and next time on Rabi-Ribi, we'll explore the laboratory and hopefully find out this Sayaro person. So, have a good day, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, take care!